Hi everyone, this is Vijay here from ENTTEC and welcome to our second YouTube Live. What we're covering today is our new Storm10 controller. The Storm10 is an upgrade of our old Storm8 controller. If you're familiar with the Storm range, you'll know that the Storm is an Ethernet to DMX converter, and the Storm10 basically adds two additional universes of DMX, giving us 10 in total. But there's four additional ports. Now that will become a little bit more clear once we open this up and have a look at what we're dealing with here. So let's go ahead and open up our Storm10. Get rid of the packaging material. And the first thing that we see here is our Storm10. So it's a very familiar looking device compared to our Storm8. We have our Ethernet port here, two additional ports on the front here, which we'll go through in a sec, status LED and reset button. And on the back, we have our familiar 8-port DMX output, two additional ports over here, a DC jack, which we can use to power it. We'll go through a bit more about the ports in a second, but first off, just want to go through the accessories section here. So we have our DC jack, which we can use to power the Storm10. We have a patch cable, which we can use to connect to network. Additional plugs as well for the different regions. So that's all included in the box. And all of our mounting ears. So we've got some rack mount ears, DIN rail clips, and that gives us all the options that we need to be able to mount our Storm10 to surfaces, DIN rails, inside a 90-inch rack. Everything's included in the box. So I'll put that aside for a second. And we can now go through in a bit more detail about the Storm10 and what it is that's new. So as before, we have our Ethernet port here. It does also accept PoE via the 802.3AF standard. So we can power by DC jack or we can power by PoE through the front here. Next to that, we have our status LED, which tells us what's going on with the Storm10 once we've plugged it in. So for example, if it's white, then it's just idle, it's booted up and it's just waiting for something to do. If it's green, then it is sending DMX and RDM. And we've also got a purple IP conflict status. So for example, if you connect it up to your device, connect it up to your network, and there's another device already on that same address, the purple indicator will come up indicating that you need to fix that IP address conflict. Next to that is our reset button. You can find more details about that in the user manual, but essentially that lets you factory reset the device. So for example, if you lost the IP address, hadn't labeled it, and you needed to restore it back to defaults, just hold that down while you power cycle the device, you can factory reset it. Now on the back, we have our DMX outputs. So we have the usual 8-port connector that we're familiar with from the Storm8, as well as two additional ports here, giving us ports 9 and 10. So that gives us our 10 universes of DMX output. Now, as we saw on the front here, we do also have two additional ports, which are also labeled 9 and 10. Now, these are a duplicate of ports 9 and 10 on the back here. So this just gives you the versatility or convenience of being able to connect devices, the DMX devices, to the front or the back of the Storm10. Now these are electrically connected, ports 9 and 10 on the front and the back. So you can connect, for example, 32 devices to front port 9, and then none on back port 9, or you can mix it up and put, say, 16 devices on back port 10. Front port 10, sorry, and another 16 on back port 10. So you have that flexibility there. We have our DC jack here as well. So if you're not using PoE, you can you can power it via the DC jack, which is provided in the box. One of the main things that one of the main improvements that we've made to the Storm range with the Storm 10 is supporting RDM over ARTnet. So if you're familiar with the Storm range, you'll be used to these ports just putting out DMX. We've made improvements to the system now so that you can use RDM over ARTnet through any of these ports, which gives you more flexibility to use this on, say, architectural facade type applications where you need RDM. And that's now all supported on there. If you're familiar with any of our ENTTEC devices for network-based devices, you'll know that when you connect to the IP address of the device, you will get to its user interface. And through the user interface, you'll be able to configure all the ports however you need them to be configured. So that gives you additional versatility because the ports that we've got here, universes 1 through 10, by default will be set to individual universes. But you can change that to match whatever you need for your project. So for example, you can keep them on separate universes. You can even bundle them up, so you can put two or three on the same universe. And basically that lets you use the Storm 10 as a mixture of an Ethernet to DMX node as well as a splitter. So a bit of extra versatility there, as well as the RDM over ARTnet letting you do more projects with the device. That's about all the features that we had to discuss with the Storm 10. So while we wait for some questions to come through, we have a question.
Excellent. Can I use RDM while I'm using SACN for my DMX data?
You can. So yeah, if you're using SACN mode, you can still use RDM using an RDM over ARTnet software, like a DMX workshop or something like that. Okay.
Another question.
Yep.
What's with the Ethernet ports on the back?
Okay. So a common misconception, these are RJ45 ports. They're not they're not necessarily Ethernet. A lot of times when we see this shape of port, we associate that with Ethernet, but it's actually just a port type, and we're using these to transmit DMX data. So if we look at the front here, now this is an RJ45 port that is Ethernet, so this is connecting us to network, and it is labeled as such. We've got a yellow halo around that. Whereas all of our other ports, all of our DMX ports here, have got green color coding on them. They are outputting DMX. They have the same shape, same port type as Ethernet, but they are actually being used to transmit DMX. It's just the port type that's being used for a different kind of data.
Can we have something plugged into ports 9 and 10 in the front and in the back at the same time?
Yes, absolutely. So ports 9 and 10 on the back and the front are electrically connected. So we just have to keep in mind the DMX limitations. So as I said before, you can have up to 32 devices, per port. So that's split between the front and the back. So if we have 32 devices, we can put say 16 on front port 9 and 16 on back port 9, or we can put all of them on, so all 32 on front port 10 and none on back port 10, for example. Okay, so that's all the questions. So let's talk about some applications for the Storm 10. Now, it is a high-density Ethernet to DMX converter. So in a relatively small unit, we have 10 universes of DMX output, and we also have RDM compatibility, RDM over ARTnet compatibility. So this really lends itself to projects involving, say, architectural or building facade, projects where we have a requirement for high density Ethernet to DMX conversion. You can also use it for DMX pixels because in those kinds of applications, we tend to run through a lot of channels very quickly. So the Storm 10 will be quite useful for that. Why I mentioned RDM earlier was especially because of the RDM capability. That is very useful for architectural and building facade or bridges, that type of application. Because as you can imagine, you don't really want to be physically, manually addressing DMX fixtures on the side of a building or on a bridge working at heights. So it's much easier to be able to connect to them using RDM over ArtNet and configure them however you need them to be configured. So that's essentially what the Storm is really geared at. But at the end of the day, it is a high-density Ethernet to DMX converter at a really good price point as well. It's pretty competitive in the market. The configurability also lends itself to being used in all sorts of other applications because, as I mentioned, you can use it as an Ethernet to DMX node, or you can group outputs together and use it as a splitter as well. So we can see this being used in all sorts of other applications where maybe limited budget, additional flexibility is required, versatility. It's a really good unit to have. Now, on that note of additional, say, project examples, we have one here on the front page of our brochure, actually. So this is a project in Indonesia that was using Storm controllers. And the reason it lent itself quite well to Storms is visible from the layout of the project. So what we have here is a multi-level structure here with lots and lots of RGBW wash light fixtures arrayed all around. So a lot of addresses in a relatively small space. So the Storm is a good option for that. Now, the Storm 10 also allows for RDM over ArtNet, which does help with that kind of installation where it might be a little bit difficult to get to fixtures once they're installed. And so you can just RDM into them and address them remotely. So that's a project example that you could use the Storm 10 for. Again, because of its versatility, we can definitely see it being used on a lot of other kinds of projects as well.
Someone was just wondering, where can they buy one?
So where can you buy one? Links are in the description. Contact your local ENTTEC office or distributor. Excellent. So I think last thing we'll want to do is plug everything together and get some lights working. So let's go ahead and plug it all in. So at the moment I'm just connecting my Storm to my laptop using the provided patch lead. Also need to give it power. So that is DC power on now. And then I can plug my DMX cable that's going to my light fixture in, like so. And then I can go to my software and start sending data. So I'm just using the EMU software at the moment. I've patched this fixture as just a RGBW wash light, and I can then increase the levels. So that's red to 255, green to 255, blue to 255, and white to 255. So there we can see I'm controlling the light in real time using ArtNet going to our Storm 10, which is then converting to DMX to control our light fixture. So for, say, a project like this or others, it would just essentially be this on a much bigger scale with more universes, more storms, and so on. I hope you guys found this YouTube Live introduction to our Storm 10 useful. If you have any other questions, please let us know. Drop us a comment in the description or reach out to your local ENTTEC team or distributor. Look forward to seeing you on the next one.